So why this warning? What is the point of the warning here? This is the pattern that we'll see throughout the rest of the letter. He's saying, we've received a much better thing. He's going to get into this whole idea of the new covenant and how good it is and how much better it is and how it's inaugurated by the blood of Christ. And he is saying to them, what do you think will happen to us if we have been given the better thing? Tread lightly with it. Now, I think a way to understand the way this argument is structured is to think back to the parable that Jesus tells. It's the parable of the sower. And he casts out seed on four different kinds of soil. You're probably familiar with it. So you've got the seed that falls into the non-ideal soil, and some of it springs up, and it looks like it's going to be viable. But then you have the seed that falls into the fertile soil, and it too springs up. And what's the difference between the three unfortunate soils and the good soil? It's that the plants that fall into the good soil produce what? Fruit. They produce fruit, but we see that there are those who will give the appearance of having responded to the gospel when in fact they had only a head knowledge or an intellectual assent and it never made it to their hearts. And so when we hear these warnings, we can always be asking the question, not, am I the person who is the hard or rocky soil? If you're a believer, you can know that you will endure because the Lord is steadfast to his covenant with you. But I think the question we can ask is, does my life look any different from someone who's only given an intellectual assent to the things of God? I think that's the question that's being posed here is, do I understand the argument, but it hasn't touched me to my core? Am I so comfortable in the knowledge that God will not cast me off and I no longer see him as someone who has every right to apart from the blood of Christ? That's how we are to hear these warnings.